Shalom, everyone. Lieutenant Colonel Jonathan from the IDF here.
Israeli soldiers inside Gaza's largest hospital, offering a guided tour of al-Shifa.
So we're inside the MRI center. A few of the most interesting things that we have found totally confirm, without any doubt, that Hamas systematically uses hospitals.
The video went on to show weapons, ammunition and combat gear uncovered, the IDF says, during the raid.
This is a grab bag, grab and go, of a Hamas combatant. And if you zoom in, there is an AK-47. There are cartridges, ammo. There are grenades in here. Of course, uniform. And all of that, this was hidden very conveniently, secretly, behind the MRI machine.
SBS can't independently verify the videos, and the footage released doesn't appear to show evidence of the underground command and control centre the IDF says sits beneath the hospital. Hamas officials deny operating at al-Shifa and are accusing the IDF of planting the weapons there. The Hamas-run health ministry also released videos from the hospital showing patients lying in the dark and hazy halls of the ICU, filled with smoke. Doctors say this is the aftermath of an Israeli airstrike, which the IDF denies.
There is continuous shooting and firing outside the hospital, inside, we don't know exactly, but it's like within the area. The tanks are continuously moving within the hospital area. Again, today, with the whole hospital is totally like, let me say, in a way, handicapped. Like, no one is operating, no one is seeing anyone.
Doctors say about 700 patients remain in al-Shifa, including 36 premature babies removed from their incubators with no fuel left to power them. The hospital says three newborns have died so far.
We didn't lose any of them over the last 24 hours, which is good, but doesn't mean that the issue has been solved now. So again, it's a big issue, but we lost five ICU patients because of the lack of the oxygen.
For the first time in almost 6 weeks, Israel has allowed fuel into the Gaza Strip. 24,000 litres have come in via the Rafah crossing, but Israel says it can only be used by the UN to distribute aid, and none of it will be sent to hospitals.
24,000 litres is not enough. My understanding is that to cover the whole of the Gazan territory and therefore all of the people in need, we would need about 200,000 litres a day.
The IDF says it has delivered aid to al-Shifa, releasing these videos of its troops carrying boxes labelled medical supplies, the offering not appeasing the UN's medical body.
Israel's military incursion into al-Shifa hospital in Gaza City is totally unacceptable. Under international humanitarian law, health facilities, health workers, ambulances, and patients must be safeguarded and protected against all acts of war.
A live grenade.
As the raid went on, the Security Council approved its first resolution on this war after four failed attempts. It calls for the immediate and unconditional release of hostages and urgent and extended humanitarian pauses. Abstaining from the vote was Russia, wanting a ceasefire, and the UK and US wanting explicit condemnation of Hamas, which they designate a terrorist organisation. But this time they didn't use their veto powers.
Although the United States is deeply disappointed by what is not in this text, we support many of the important provisions this council has adopted.
Israel's ambassador to the UN called the resolution meaningless and said the IDF will continue to fight until Hamas is destroyed. Claudia Farhart, SBS World News.